It's Martin Jennings here from Lung and Sleep. In this short video, I'm going to demonstrate to you the usefulness of radial EBUS in biopsying peripheral lung lesions. Now, radial EBUS has a lot of advantages over a CT-guided biopsy. The main ones are that it's able to access lesions that are not accessible to CT-guided biopsy. The risk of pneumothorax is extremely low. It's probably less than 1%, where the risk for pneumothorax with a CT-guided biopsy is somewhere between 10 and 20%. The other advantage is that it gives us an opportunity to investigate the central airways and exclude an obstructing lesion or an endobronchial lesion. And we can also use linear EBUS to look at the lymph nodes within the mediastinum and the hilum, so we can stage the mediastinum at the same time as biopsying the peripheral lesion. So now I'm going to show you a few slides, and I'm going to use a case study to demonstrate how radial EBUS works and how it allows us to biopsy lesions in the lung. So here's a case study of a 74-year-old man who had a history of 40-pack year smoking, and there was an incidental finding on a CT scan of the chest of a right upper lobe nodule. This is a common situation where a CT scan is done for another reason and there's an incidental finding of a nodule. Here's the CT scan demonstrating the nodule, which is situated in the right upper lobe. This is at the level of the carina. This is the left main bronchus and the right main bronchus. And this is heading up to the right upper lobe bronchus here, and you can see the anterior segment and the posterior segment. And here you can see there's a nice airway sign. The posterior segment leads straight to this lesion. Now this measures about 1.5 centimetres or 15 millimetres. Has a spiculated border, and it looks very concerning for a lung cancer. This is showing the mediastinal windows, and this is showing that there's no lymphadenopathy. This lymph node here is the right paratracheal lymph node, or 4R, and this measures about 3 or 4 millimetres. Has a fatty hilum on the CT. That's a good sign that lymph node will be benign. Subcarinal lymph node, there's not really any lymph node there. There might be a very small one. There's not really much of a lymph node there in the right hilum. So here's the PET scan. And the PET scan shows us areas of the body that are highly metabolic of glucose. And so here, this area goes black because it's detecting a high amount of glucose metabolism. And these are the fused images where they go yellow to demonstrate the increased uptake on the PET scan. Now this raises the suspicion of a cancer because lung cancers do tend to be high in metabolism of glucose. However, it doesn't mean that it certainly is a cancer, and it's not diagnostic because other things such as infection or granulomas can also look like a cancer on the CT and can also be highly metabolic of glucose, so they light up on the PET scan. So we still need to go and biopsy this lesion. One of the problems with traditional bronchoscopy is that the bronchoscope can only access the central airways. So here's a diagram demonstrating that the bronchoscope, which has a diameter of between 3 and 4 millimetres, depending on your scope, can only reach to get out to the lobar or segmental airways, because once it gets to that point, the airways are too small and the bronchoscope can no longer extend. So if you have a tumour within the central airways that you can see from the bronchoscopy, it's quite easy to biopsy it. However, beyond this central area, so if a tumour's sitting here, for example, or down here, there's no way that we would be able to see them. And this is where radial EBUS is really important, to be able to find the nodule beyond the vision of the bronchoscope. So in this case, I know that my bronchoscope is only going to reach this far. So I'm not going to see this nodule. I will see the right main bronchus, the upper lobe, and I'll see these segments, but I won't see beyond those because the bronchoscope will not be able to fit into this small airway. So radial EBUS is going to be very important to make sure I'm in the right airway and that I don't head off into a wrong airway and biopsy the wrong part of the lung. And so this is the radial EBUS. Radial EBUS is an ultrasound. EBUS stands for endobronchial ultrasound. And this is the ultrasound here, and it spins around in a radial fashion.
It's sitting within a guide sheath here, which is just a plastic sheath with a metal tip. The metal tip allows us to see where it is on the fluoroscopic images during the procedure. And the ultrasound pokes out beyond the guide sheath so that it can be placed into the lung, and it will be able to tell whether the ultrasound is within the air-filled lung or whether it's within a solid lesion. Now I'll show you how this works. Here's the guide sheath as a schematic drawing, and within the guide sheath is the ultrasound transducer. Here's the tumour. Once the ultrasound goes into the tumour, you can see on the ultrasound image that it's within a solid lesion. You then take the ultrasound out, and you're left with the guide sheath in place, taking you straight to where the tumour is. Within the guide sheath, you can then put your biopsy forceps or your cytology brush through the guide sheath, and that will take you straight to within the tumour, so you can be sure that you're taking your samples from within the tumour. Now this is back to our case study, and this is the endobronchial appearance of the right upper lobe. Here's the apical segment, the posterior segment, and the anterior segment. Now from the CT scan, we could see that this posterior segment is probably the segment that is going to contain the lesion. Here we've got the endobronchial appearance, and this is the radial EBUS. So right in the middle here is the EBUS probe, and that's what gets put out into the lung parenchyma. And what we'll see here is a change in the ultrasound image depending on whether the ultrasound is within the air of the lung or whether it's within the solid tumour. I'll just play this for you. Here you'll see there's the spinning radial EBUS probe coming out, going into the posterior segment. Now, just pause it there. This is just a bit of artifact. There's probably a bit of a blood vessel here. This is mostly air artifacts from being within the normal air of the lung. Further into the lung parenchyma, we'll see the ultrasound go to within the solid lesion. So here we're pushing the ultrasound out. Here's normal air appearance of the lung, and there we're coming into the solid lesion now. So you can see that this area here is now solid. This white area is hyperechoic, the hyperechoic border of this lesion. So this is a great ultrasound image showing us that the ultrasound here is actually within the lesion, surrounded by solid tumour. As we push the probe further in, we can get a bit of an idea as to the size of the lesion and the depth beyond our vision. There you can see it's a bit bigger at that point. There we've pushed past the lesion, we're just coming back into it. We get an idea as to exactly the position of that lesion. Now this is the fluoroscopic image. Here we can see the bronchoscope, and coming out of the tip of the bronchoscope is the ultrasound, the radial EBUS, within the guide sheath. This is the metal tip of the guide sheath, so you can see where it is, and this is the tip of the ultrasound. Now, on the fluoroscopy, we can't really see the nodule there. So we know that we're in the right place because the ultrasound showed us that we're within the lesion. But if we were relying on fluoroscopy only, we would not know that that was in the right place. Now we've removed the ultrasound from within the guide sheath and replaced it with biopsy forceps. And you can see that the biopsy forceps open there and I'm about to take a biopsy. And I know that that biopsy is from within the lesion. And the pathology came back confirming that this was an adenocarcinoma of the lung. Based on the staging that I demonstrated, that there was no metastases to high-level mediastinal lymph nodes or beyond. This was a stage 1A tumour, and the most appropriate treatment for that is surgical resection with a right upper lobectomy, and that would be done with curative intent. The pathological staging after that lobectomy in this case confirmed that the lymph nodes were all negative, which is a very good prognostic sign and also tells us that there will be no benefit from any adjuvant therapy, so this patient does not need any chemotherapy and should be cured of their tumour.